So this is Donya, Manager of Marketing at Actros Aviations Private Limited. And today I'll be giving a small presentation on workplace happiness and employee motivation. Just share this. Workplace happiness, its benefits, and employee motivation, and how to make sure, how to manage it. First of all, we need to understand what workplace happiness actually means. So workplace happiness, if you talk from an employee perspective, it actually means that the employee really enjoys what they do and they are proud of themselves and the work they do. So because of this, they are happy to come to work and they enjoy being around people at work, and because of which they will actually have a better performance. So if you look at what the benefits are of having a happy workplace, we can see that it encourages the employees to work harder. And again, the reason is because the employee is actually happy coming to work and they love the work that they do. So they are automatically encouraged to work more, work harder, and contribute more to the organization. And this would again, in turn, increase their productivity. And a lot of studies have also suggested that happy employees actually are more loyal to the organization than unhappy ones, because they find that because they feel that they ought to give something back to the organization in return for the efforts that the organization takes to make sure that their workplace is happy. And another benefit is that happy employees are usually healthier, which again increases the productivity of the organization. Now, when you look at the steps to ensure the happy employees, first one is to appreciate your employees. Usually what happens in most of the organization is that people wait until the annual reviews to give feedback and appreciate and so on. But it is better not to wait until the end of the year to actually give appreciation. It's always better to give appreciation as often as you can, as and when an opportunity arises, because this will boost the morale of the employee. And this will also create a very positive work environment. Another one is to be flexible. A company or an organization or a team which has very tight schedule with very strict breaks or exactly 15 minutes break and so on would not be very attractive to an employee from an employee's point of view. So organizations which are providing a flexible timing actually make sure that the employees have a better control over their work-life balance. So most of the organizations, like top organizations, have now shifted to becoming flexible, providing flexible work timings, and only the deadlines are fixed. How you do your work is up to the team member itself. And this would in turn increase the job attractiveness. Then another one is promote organization. So an organized workspace is... So if you can look at this picture itself, it looks very soothing, and it will actually increase your focus to have a workplace like this, which is more organized. So this will reduce stress, it will make things easier, and it will provide better focus. And looking at it, it provides a sense of calm, which again increases productivity. Then another one is to be a team player. This is this point is especially to the team leads who are expected to lead by example. So instead of being a boss, a manager has to be a team leader or a leader. So here you have to work with your team members, get your hands dirty. Whatever is the problem that the team members are facing, it will be your problem to you to guide them through it. And whatever hard work that the members are putting into the work, that has to be rewarded by the team leader as well. Then another one is to promote a social workplace. So if a workplace is very individualized, wherein a person sits alone in the cabin and does the work by himself without having any informal relations with the employees, would be very sad, and there would not be any satisfaction an employee gets from such a workplace. So it is up to the organization to make sure that the workplace is very much social, and employees are motivated to speak freely and to share their thoughts freely and their opinions as well freely. So this can be achieved through having weekly meetings, discussing anything good that is happening in the firm. Like, for example, a teammate has achieved something which was exceptional. So you have a meeting and talk about it, like how they achieved it and so on. And also, many companies now follow team dinner and team party or team outing practices to strengthen the social aspect in the team. Another one is paying attention to the physical work environment. So it is already proven through studies that a workplace which actually has a good scenery and has a lot of plants around, it automatically gives the employees a sense of calmness and happiness, and it would again boost the productivity of that employee. So it actually points that such a workplace is actually promoting happy employees. Now coming to employee motivation. So if you look at employee motivation, you can see that it is actually the energy level or the enthusiasm that an employee brings to the organization, brings to the team. And along with it, the amount of creativity also that they bring. So once an employee is motivated, then the employee becomes more productive in the team for the organization. And motivation can be two types, extrinsic and intrinsic. Extrinsic would be pay hikes or any monetary and motivation that is being given. And intrinsic would be any applauses, appreciation, or that something that is not monetary, but more emotional. Now, if you look at the benefits of motivated employees, here also we can see that there is high productivity levels because a motivated employee would actually be willing to work more and put in more efforts into the work that they're doing. Along with that, it increases the innovation and thinking out the out-of-the-box thinking of the employee. It would also result in lower absenteeism and lower staff turnover because here, if an employee is motivated, then that means they're motivated to work and they want to contribute more to the organization. And this would also increase the reputation of the organization in the job market and such, and thus the recruitment would be stronger. Now, thinking of the steps to boost employee motivation, one would be recognizing great work. So as per studies, it is said that 70% of the employees actually state that their morale and motivation improves when they receive recognition from management. If a manager or a teammate is able to make sure that any work that is put in by a teammate is being recognized, then it would actually improve the employee motivation, which results in happy employees. This would actually promote consistency in high-performing employees. This is because once a high-performing employee does something good, if you do not reward them, if you do not recognize it, they are not motivated to repeat the work that they have done. And how you recognize is also important because just directly telling someone good job and ending it there would not really pass off as a good type of recognition, and they would not feel satisfied. So recognition maybe it need not be very huge, but you can elaborate what it is that they did, or it can be a group mail sent to the entire team or something of that. Then another one is to set small and measurable goals. So this is important to increase employee motivation because the smaller the goal, it is better achievable. So it does not look like a Herculean task. It looks like something that is achievable, and thus the employee is willing to work towards it because they're motivated because they know that it is achievable. And this will keep the team on the right track. And along with that, it actually provides many more opportunity to reward or to motivate the employees because smaller goals means more goals. Now, celebrating results is another point. In continuation with the previous point, we just discussed that it provides a lot more opportunities. Smaller goals will provide more opportunities. So these opportunities must be taken up to reward and applaud the employees. The celebration need not be very big. It can just be a small team meeting wherein team lead would applaud the employee in front of the entire team and specifically mention what it is that they did and what is the impact that it caused to the organization. Another one is to be transparent. Most of the employees right now, they prefer transparent companies over companies which have high importance of hierarchy and confidentiality. So this is because if a person or a manager or an organization is transparent and provides all information that they have that is required for the job, it would increase the employees' trust in the team and in the leader. So it would also make sure that all the employees work with the same information. There is no way in which one employee has more information. That is why they are able to work better and so on. Another one is to provide clarity. This is actually a follow-up of providing transparency. So if you are transparent and you provide all the information clearly, provide all the information to the employees, but the information is something that you can't figure out. You can't understand what the head is and what the toe is. So here, clarity comes into picture, wherein the information that is being passed on has to be clear and concise. Everyone should be able to work with the same information and the same interpretation of the information. Then another one is to provide a sense of security. This is very basic, wherein employers have to give employees a feeling of job security and sense of security, wherein they know that they won't lose their job directly, or they are that the organization cares for them. So it is only then that the employee is motivated to show their full self, and this will be able to improve innovation and enable the employees to speak out more about their opinions, their points of view, and so on. So as I just mentioned, the security can be in the form of job security or health security or mental health issues. Then another important factor is finding purpose. So if an employee is given a work directly by a teammate without any idea of what is the impact that it is having in the organization, there would be not a lot of motivation by the employees to actually do that work. So here, the finding purpose comes into picture, wherein the employees have to be made known about what is the impact of that work that they're doing, what is the purpose of that work, and how is it going to translate into the organization goals. So this will boost the motivation of the employee, and they will have a better idea of what is expected out of them as well. Then the last one is loosen the reins. So here again, flexible work schedules come into picture, wherein if you have a very autocratic mode of leadership, wherein everything is very stringent and micromanagement is followed, so this will make the employee very demotivated to work, and to it kills autonomy as well. So if you loosen the reins a little, the employee would be motivated to give in their best, and autonomy also helps in making sure that the employee's full potential is used in work over here. Thank you, and I hope this presentation helped you understand what is workplace happiness, what is employee motivation, and how you can achieve it, as well as what the benefits are.